I ran into some locals in the ruins of a children's summer camp. Looks like they're not too fond of tourists. So that's what she meant when she said I should stay out of sight. Still, I must reach the dam. My radio got drenched and I couldn't return the calls from the Aurora. Ama is worried. I should visit the church on the way. It's a notable landmark. Alyosha might be waiting for me there.
Is the final exam. I am ready. I'm not afraid, even though I couldn't even defend myself. Forgive me, teacher.
Thank you. not alone. Ha!
All right, let's cut the rope and take him to the camp with the first one.
Hey, wait a minute. You pioneers already have one, and this is our catch.
He got caught on our turf.
The net is mine, so bite me.
Oh, yeah? Well, why did you set the trap on our turf, then? Besides, you already have an intruder's backpack.
I dived for the backpack, and you chickened out.
Oh, I chickened out? You're pirates! You have more boats! And this one will face the forest court.
Bojumoy, you're all cowards. He's an intruder, an enemy.
What are you, a bandit? What did the teacher say? He said we must be different. Did you forget?
Isn't your head getting a bit too big? The teacher said we have to defend ourselves first. All the rest was later. Did you forget what the intruders would do here? He's an intruder too, so he must die before he brings the others.
Enough! The forest court comes first. The court will decide if we kill him.
So you got out, you asshole. It takes real skill to get away from the master of the forest. This means you're dangerous. Damn it. Fucking backpack. I got greedy. Well, shoot me. Or scram. I gotta get ready. For the final exam. Tell the teacher. I defended ours. Didn't chicken out. Didn't bully the girls. Teacher, I'm here.
What do you think? It's a hit from the master. The master probably got Eugene too. You went to the camp, we came here. It all took time. So what? We must at least get the bodies back. We'd be called cowards if we don't.
Yep. Let's push it then.
Yeah. Tell me one thing though. How did you guys manage not to see the master? He can walk silently. And we were distracted. Another intruder got caught in the trap. And you got excited and started to mangle all the roof. Or at least the boots. Another intruder? Weird that Olga didn't say anything. And didn't even come with us. Well, so where is he? He's still hanging out there. If the master didn't get there.
What? More reason to hurry up then.
Yeah, let's pick up some speed.
Something's wrong with me today.
I see her! It's her!
I surrender, Drifter! I can't do anything anymore! I surrender, but don't expect me to kiss your boots. You're an intruder here.
I didn't detect the intruders. First, I only had to shoot once and I kept my eyes shut that time. And it was you who attacked us and raped and killed. We were only defending ourselves. You won't shoot.
Well, if you're not going to shoot, then it's true that some intruders are kinda okay. We are pioneers. We only kill the bandits. The pirates, though, they just turn intruders into pincushions, not waiting for the forest court. They also rob, like bandits do. We're different, even though we grew up together. We do as the teacher told us to, but they misinterpret his words.
Hey!
They took one of yours to the kin. He didn't look like a bandit either. They'll probably let him go after the forest court.
Besides, Olga likes him, and she's an instructor.
Just don't kill our people in the camp. There are women and children. Don't hurt them, please. You can go around the guards, through the cave, or by boat. Just don't hurt anyone, please.
You summoned the council, so take the word first.
You don't respect the teacher's word. What is that supposed to mean?
You let an intruder go. You could leave the others here. We have all of our possessions here.
Nobody let him go. He escaped. The guard was distracted, and he's being punished.
Well, more intruders come and start cutting you to pieces. That's going to be a great help.
You'll be running around pissing your pants and shouting, "We punish the guards!" Or maybe you'll just surrender.
Running is your forte. You said you were going to hold the lumber mill and ran.
Don't you dare! The boys died there to the last man! The deadlands are spreading. Holding that is harder than keeping one intruder under a lock!
And we will hold the swamp camp. Don't be afraid, weaklings.
You say that again and I'll deck you. Watch your tone.
But he was saying shit about the boys who died there.
All right. Anyhow, you pioneers shut your pants. Now we'll have to board the train. Better than waiting for them back.
Remember the teacher's word. We defend ourselves.
Attack is the best form of defense.
What? I don't remember the teacher saying that.
The teacher said you have to read. So we read that in our book.
Well, if you read that in your book, then you can attack. And we won't. The teacher also said that you can't just kill everyone. You'll have to take them to the forest court.
Ah, we expect it.
expected as much from you. All right, we can handle it ourselves. And we'll hang the second intruder from a post once we catch him.
He's not a bandit, and he didn't hurt the girls. He only defended himself. Why kill him?
Because he's an intruder. Because he came here like a bandit, so he'll get hanged like one. And I dare you to say we are bandits.
Is that a threat?
It's a warning.
Enough! I declare the session closed! And now, as hospitality dictates, let's eat together.
The hell with those fools? I don't want to eat with them. Besides, I had something cooking. Call that!
That Sashka is damn lucky. Bonked one intruder in the head, and now he's on fast lane into the teacher's house and his vows. He's an instructor now.
But he earned that. That intruder was tough. There were three of our guys around.
So what? Does that make hitting him from behind a big deal?
If it's such a small deal, then I bet you could do it too. Just get the stick and hit the next intruder that comes with it if you fancy teacher's house so much.
I might do just that. And you, don't you feel jealous guarding the house and never even entering it? Sure. Marcus always there, but is he better than us?
Boy, you are salty. Durka's a guard there, a damn honor guard. He can't even sit down for a moment. The others are making vows while he stands at attention.
This attitude won't make you an instructor anytime soon.
And I don't really give a shit.
Stinks like something died. I guess I'll go wash the sweat off.
How long do you think Vitya is going to stand in the corner for?
No idea. Roman will decide that when he's back.
Why? I just think we shouldn't have put him there. It wasn't he who told the lie. It was a victim.
Well, you were punished for being dumb, not for lying. You can't really be so stupid when you're targets. You got lucky that the Richter just left. You slipped a couple of strokes. Yeah, that is true. Where do you think he went to that Richter? Vitya said he was heading for the church. Why did you get chased at? Well, he didn't harm us at all. Besides, who's gonna mind the camp if we all chase him, huh? Imagine if the master comes. Oh, I guess I didn't think this through. Yeah, Vitya didn't hear it. Could see where it got him.
Are you right in there?
From him.
Sure I am. What else could I do?
Now go on like this. I won't let you off the hook until you write 10 pages.
I will be brave. I will protect. I will never bully. It's gonna take me till nightfall like this.
Don't worry, I've got time. I can give you till tomorrow morning if you need me. It's all right.
How much longer do I have to spend here? It's unbearable.
Yeah, right. It's still going to say it.
Well, why not? Diligence is the mother of success.
Well, go be diligent somewhere instead of wasting time.
I just finished the patrol and am now enjoying my free time, so get on my case.
Free time is for rest, and you're going to lose your bonus if you continue like that.
What's that to you?
Nothing. You could go mute for all I care, but this thing isn't going to say a word anyways.
Why? Even you can talk, and it's much smarter than you, that's for sure.
Ah, shut up.
Stay there, I don't care. Nobody cares.
Man, what do we do now? They're both out.
Well, just do the work yourself if you're so smart.
I told you we should have just killed them. They aren't going to talk anyway.
Just kill them? Ever find hanging on one of their posts with wolves nibbling at your feet? They have a lot to answer for.
Aren't you taking this a little too personal? You sure don't look like you've been on a post.
I haven't, but my friends have. Now continue these two fuckers. How many fingers did he have left?
now.
What a shitty spot this is. Freaks, mutants, just one fucking thing after another.
What's up, guys? He's...
No, people. What's at that fence?
People! The fucker thinks we ain't gonna find his ass. Well, you know what that means. You just have to prove he's nothing but a little bitch with a bad case of wishful thinking. Come on! Slit your wrist there or something, you shit eater! Cause you're gonna be fucking sorry that we're gonna...
Well, you're fucking gonna get it now!
You're dead already, you motherfucker! Come out, I'll cut you up quickly!
Come out, you fucker, before I go really mad on your ass!
Where is that fucker?
I see the fucker! He's in the house! Over here!
There!
Take this, you fucker!
Thank you.
guy! Stop pinching there! Stop pinching there!
Something down there, or is it just me?
Let me tell you one thing, you fucker. You ain't getting away, that's like for sure.
Well, you're fucking gonna get it now!
Fuck, think you can get away? Well, I'm sure as fuck gonna rain on your parade and nab your ass soon. The bitch is there! Catch a bullet, you motherfucker!
This shit, guys!
I'm gonna get that fucker.
Fuck! We're royally fucked! I see the fucking bastard! You're fucked!
I'm there, look! I'll fucking rip your ass in two!
For a while. Well, that bitch went into hiding. Well, I'm just gonna have to dig him up now.
Bitch ran somewhere else.
No
fucking not for
way
long, not for
this.
Long, mate.
You dumb bitch.
Easier. That's not the fucking one. fucker thinks we ain't gonna find his ass.
You fucking bitch!
Hey guys, we have to find the fucker before he fucking runs off!
I don't fucking get.
Some more, you bitch.
So you're not one of them, I see. Thanks for saving us, stranger. Thank you. Oh, damn, friend. How did it even come out this way? Well, you're at the final exam now. You'll pass it with flying colors, I know it. When you see the teacher, tell him we will survive, like he taught us. Still.
Thank you.
Freeze, Drifter! So, we meet again? Though I bet you don't remember who dragged you out of the water. My name is Olga, by the way. Was it you fighting the Master of the Forest? Awesome. Our hunters had been staying away from him for years. Damn it! Sorry, teacher. The locks all rusted up. Your friend Alyosha is already at the dam. He said your colonel won't wait, so you don't have much time. Sorry, I can't take you there. At today's council session, the pirates moved to attack your train, but they had no right to even call one without me present. As usual, I need to go and sort this out. But I have a few minutes to give you some directions. You need a boat to get to the dam. And our pirates keep all the boats at their swamp camp. They are not the sharing kind, but that's no reason to attack. Nobody wants bloodshed, so just stay out of their sight. Take the road to the barricade. Go down to the swamp and find the dock. That's where Alyosha and I took the boat from. Dieter, forgive me. There are some left, but be careful. Well, Drifter, take care. And don't make me sorry I helped you people. Tell Alyosha I said hi. I'll stay a bit longer to tend to the grave of the teacher. Decided to relax a bit before the trip. That's a good idea. And I'm stuck in thought here. Once the Master decided to haunt the vicinity, people all but stopped coming here, though they haven't forgotten. The teacher raised us all, taught us how to survive in the forest. If not for him, we'd all be long dead. So the girls used to come here every day, and the boys still make it from time to time. Even Roman does visit, though it was because of him that the teacher left back then. Most of us went on a trip down the river. There were just a few people left on duty in the camp. When we came back, we found it raided by bandits. It still pains me to remember the scene. Can't even describe it. Once we and the younger group were done crying, the teacher was digging the graves alone. The elder boys were nowhere to be seen. We helped the teacher with burying ours. It was dark already when the boys returned and sat around the campfire. Roman was so covered with blood. You could only see his eyes and teeth. Then, they started talking. Tracking was easy. The bandits didn't even try covering their tracks. So the boys waited till they all got drunk in their camp and shot them with bows. Then Roman knifed the wounded like they were deer. The teacher just sat there listening. I can still see his children. And he didn't say anything. Anything at all. They understood what he meant anyway. Come morning, he was gone. To his church. At first, he wouldn't speak to anyone. But us girls kept checking up on him. Just to bring him some berries, or ask for advice. And gradually, he started speaking to us. Still, he was like a different man, so distant. He never talked to the older boys anymore, though he'd reply to their letters. And to the rest of us who'd keep visiting him, he would always say we had to become their conscience. Keep them from becoming monsters. But how do you do that? And they didn't stop at that either. Started calling themselves pirates, made the flooded lumber mill in the swamp their private HQ. Then they started hanging bandits from the posts, calling them musts. One day they took about 10 bandits alive and used them to test all the boys. Made them kill the bastards. None of ours could do it. And they all got called cowards for that, and then got ostracized. That's how the pioneers came to be. Of course, they all calmed down by now. They are talking to each other, at least. But back then, only Luda and I could speak for the teacher at the council meetings. In the end, Luda and a few boys just couldn't take it anymore and left. I wonder if they found a better place to live. I still keep checking the radio, hoping to hear from them. The teacher hoped too, but that hope didn't last long. They left in July. And in September, he shot himself. That seemed to get through to Roman. He got calmer. Some of the elder guys went over to the pioneers. After all, the important thing is that we stay together. So now I have an important voice at the council. 'Cause I can kick ass if they don't listen. And not just because they're not supposed to hurt girls. A fair fight is a fair fight. Thing is, the only one I lost to in a fair fight was Roman. And even then, I gave him a blue eye he had to wear for a week. That earned his respect. The one I had the most trouble with was the Admiral. He was Roman's right-hand man. Wouldn't leave the lumber mill no matter what. Kept saying we must defend it if we don't want the mutants to eat the whole valley. But the radiation levels kept climbing there. Roman checked it with the counter himself. So at one council meeting, Roman and our instructors had everyone vote against the Admiral. And the pirates went on to build a new fort near the shore, where it's still okay to stay. The Admiral would have none of that. So he and his most hardcore flunkies stayed at the mill. I never heard from them again. Radiation's not to be played with. The teacher didn't warn us all for nothing. So now, without the Admiral, there is nobody who'd dare give me any trouble in the council. I'll put a leash on them tonight, all right. Don't you worry. I just need some time to gather my thoughts. I don't like politics, really. You could listen to the teacher's diary if you like. He kept recording it, as if he knew. Yes, I must have heard it 100 times already and still we let him down. We really did.
The radio's silent. My last hope for giving them a positive goal, leading them out of this forest dead end, was a complete fluke. Where did I go wrong? How could these great, talented, active, brave, honest, friendly children who would actively seek justice turn into monsters? Sure, I'm no Pestalozzi, but I did all I could. And even more, I gave them all my soul, my life. And what did that result in? A society of shut-ins who only respect strength and are no less cruel than the bandits they fight. Yes, some of them kept their purity, shrugged off the bad influence, and ended up leaving. I gave them all the fuel I had. But how few they were. Most changed. Could it be that in this world that routinely changes even the harmless animals into nightmarish freaks, mankind simply has no future? What is there to hope for? What's the point of even going through the motions anymore?
Well, at tonight's council session, I'm going to remind them all what the teacher thought in the end. I'll give them a piece of my mind. Did the teacher save us all so that we could just attack people? Defending ourselves is one thing, but attacking? They can't deny that, and we'll have to stand down. Those pirates. Oh, boys.
Damn, our luck's just getting worse for the day.
What are you going on about?
Who? Who's... Not what, but whom? Do you know the drifter that the pioneers caught?
Yeah, what about it?
That guy got away. But the problem is, he was not alone.
So what? We'll catch them all anyways.
The first one, maybe. The second one, no. Is a tough catch. Lots of people tried, no dice.
That's one sneaky bastard. Which means if we catch him...
Yeah. So keep your eyes peeled. This is our chance to become instructors.
Do you know if anybody went to the church today?
Don't think anyone did. Why?
I heard shooting like there was no tomorrow. But it was the bandits again. Then I saw the trees falling. Someone got the master mad.
I heard that too. That was definitely not one of our guys. We've no fools here.
Must have been the intruder.
Yeah, must have.
You think he got away?
I doubt that. The master doesn't go around.
Yeah.
What's that?
Oh, nobody. Better than the master of the forest, I must say.
Just one measly bend. Have nothing to fear. There he is! There! Look down! The intruder is here, guys! Take this, you bastard!
It was the bandits again. Then I saw the trees falling. Someone got the master mad.
I heard that too. That was definitely not one of our guys. We've no fools here.
Damn this place. Even the mosquitoes are crazy.
Yeah, must have.
You think he got away?
I doubt that. What the master that doesn't joke around. Nobody. That's crazy.
I think there's something over there. What's in that pass? Who's there? There! Look down!
It's... You bandit scum!
I see that bandit! He's in the passage! There you are!
Guys, we've no fools here.
Why am I even at this place?
Must have been the intruder.
Yeah, must have.
You think he got away?
I doubt that. The master doesn't joke around.
Who's there?
Let's see. Nothing yet again. Squirrels, I guess.
Hey, something just moved in that house, I think. That bastard. I'll find him. Nothing to be afraid of.
The intruder is here, guys!
There he is! The intruder! He's here! Just one measly bandit. I have nothing to fear. There he is!
The traitor thinks he can hide from us. Let's prove that even a squirrel couldn't hide from us in this forest.
Guys, we've no fools here.
Why would the intruders want
must
to go
have been
here?
The intruder.
Yeah, must have.
You think he got away?
I doubt that. The master doesn't joke around.
Yeah.
Who could be? Look, there's something down there. See it? What's in that house?
Okay, you never know what it could be, but I have to check it.
Well, what?
That movement here.
Thank you.
Cut your tongue, so you can't knock on the door anymore, eh? As the teacher said, courtesy distinguishes us from bandits and other animals. Wait a moment. You're not one of ours. A bandit, then. Don't look like one. Though you never know with them bandits. Different shit every day. Am I right or what, Senya?
You're always right, Admiral, sir.
Put a sock in it. Your nose is brown enough. Where was I? Ah, the bandit. Well, you're here. Which means that all those spineless worms and wannabe pirates are all dead. Am I right? Don't bother answering. Everyone knows I'm right. And good riddance, I say.
Perhaps we should offer him our hospitality, Admiral, sir. He is a guest, even though he's a bandit.
Ah, that's an idea. Take a seat, bandit. Let's have some tea. I bet you never tried anything quite like it. I gathered, dried, and brewed it myself. Can't get any help from this worthless lot. At least, they don't eat much. Hey, boys? Yeah!
Trying our best, Admiral, sir!
Ah, quit your yapping. Making a worse racket than the damn aquas in heat. No respect for our guest, either. He can't get a word in edgewise. Don't mind them. To our meeting. That's a good tea. The fussy, ground-loving rats don't drink it, though.
Radiation! Radiation!
Radiation, my ass!
Radiation!
Just look at us!
Dangerous.
We're all healthy as can be! Thanks for coming here. See how happy my boys are? We don't really have anyone to talk to here anymore.
They all left.
We're all but forgotten here. Even Roman forgot about us. Yet he was here with us when we built this base. All the boys remember that. Don't you now?
Yes, he was here!
I remember. We all remember. That's right, boys. You all remember. But that bastard just forgot! And the other ground-loving rats, too! They all forgot! We're protecting them all with our lives here. At first, they were so happy. They shouted, "We'll kill all the bandits! The pioneers are cowards! The teacher is wrong! We're better off attacking!" Didn't they, boys?
Yeah, they did!
They shouted their throats sore! Yeah, louder than those bandits we shot! There you have it. My boys do remember. And those don't. You could always count on them when you wanted someone to shout and call pioneers' names. Aye, but when the going got tough, and the Aquas started attacking in their hundreds, they changed their tune. Oh, radiation! Oh, it's dangerous! Oh, the girls say, teacher told them to tell us that we have to get out! Well, fighting the Aquas ain't as fun as hanging bandits from the posts. You can rob the bandits when you kill them, but mutants don't have much worth taking. So who cares if they're about to eat the whole valley, right? Pathetic rats. That's who they are.
Ground-loving rats.
A bit late to start listening to the teacher, too. Though, those rats don't care whom they listen to. Be it teacher or the girls. If doing so gives them an excuse for chickening out. So, they all left. The cowards. Even the pioneers have more spine than that slime. They followed Ludmilla to the dam. They were going to take the tunnels and then go along the reservoir, those adventurers. I've no idea if they actually got anywhere. But they weren't afraid of no radiation, that's for certain. Well, the only person who still has balls in that sorry lot is Olga. She did visit us a lot here, and she always thrashed those cowards at council sessions.
Visit us, my ass! It's you who she visit!
Yeah, right. Me! Though, if not for my spine wound, Olga and I would have turned this valley upside down. But now, who needs a cripple? To hell with her! A woman on a ship is bad luck. Besides, we stayed with you. Yes, my boys did stay here. I had to do some persuading to make them stay, though. Even you were going to abandon your old friend, weren't you? Weren't you?
Come on, Admiral, sir. We'd never do that.
Yeah, yeah. Tell that to this new guy. He seems to be all ears. But I can read you all like a book. And I say, you are going to leave me. And had I not brewed my tea extra super strong that day, you would have. No doubt about that. Hey, careful with the guitar!
Got it, sir. I'll be careful.
Come on, remember, this thing is an instrument!
Yes, sir. An instrument!
What the hell is up with you today? Do you want to scrub the deck so bad?
Sorry, Admiral.
Don't be sorry. Be better! How about you play something instead of dropping that guitar? I'd go for a shanty.
Yes, Admiral. One shanty coming up!
To hell with her! To hell! You're all ground-loving rats! Rats!
Yes, I've been thinking. Why don't we have a smoke? I say we should. Oh, this is good. Strong, the way I like it. This tea is as good for smoking as it is for brewing. It can also cure any sickness and solve your marital problems. The smell is an acquired taste, but I like it a lot. And my boys here don't have any problems with it. Not anymore. Just stay here with us. Living here is fun. We can talk, eat, and drink all we want. We'll find you a bunk tomorrow. I'll take a nap in the meantime. Just a little rest.
Good tea. Good tea.
Thank you. Come get some!
Artyom? Damn, you're alive! I'm so glad to see you. And I just managed to get in contact with the Aurora. They are worried. And I get that. This place isn't as simple as it first seemed. Come, I'll show you. Let's go, Artyom. Hear the counter-react? There's a hell of a lot of radioactive sediment behind that concrete. And soon, it'll bring an end to this valley. Because the dam barely holds. Use your binoculars if you don't believe me. We can't stay here. Nobody can, really. Ah, well, see that zipline? Those kids built it, back when there wasn't as much seepage. That's where we need to go. The old man said the Aurora will soon be on the dam. We gotta hurry. I think something's wrong at the Aurora. It seems that Anna is not doing too good. We'll know more soon. Come on, Artyom! Damn, that is a lot of dirt! Man, I gotta tell you, I met this awesome girl here. She's drop-dead gorgeous. Name's Olga, an instructor. Everyone respects her. Plus, she's pretty understanding. Believe me when I said we're not enemies. She was the one who let me go from their camp. Love. I kept telling you people about my animal magnetism. So, here's your proof. She was so smitten. She even walked with me. And, you know, this is something new for me. I hated to say goodbye. I asked her to come with us. I can't leave them all. She's so strong.
Of a freaking house.
Hear that? I think it smelled us. You alive there? Huh? What the hell? Goddamn! Eat this! Artyom! Get out of there!
Shit!
Thank you.
What an enormous beast! Well, Artyom, help me here! Let's restore this line's tension! We're done. Olga!
I told you people, they just needed passage.
Are you sure you're not coming?
I'm sorry, Alyosha. I can't just up and leave like this. No matter how much I like you.
In this case, I bid you farewell, my fair lady. Ah, to hell with it. Olga, I'll be back.
I'll be waiting.
Artyom, let's go! Olga! Remember what I told you! Get them out of the valley! There's death behind the dam! I just hope she convinces them! They are stubborn like children, I guess! Even though they look like beasts, those pioneers, huh? Ah, she'll handle them all right!
You guys really had us worried there.
Anna is in bad shape. We must move. Time is short. Neither the air nor the drugs we found along the way are of any help now. The illness has progressed too far. Come!
We all remained silent while the Aurora was running along the poison sea held at bay by the dam. We believed we'd be back. Now, having seen the sword of Damocles hanging over the valley, we knew it was not meant to be. Alyosha is especially worried. His Olga is there. Perhaps he will be able to warn her via radio and save the people there. What happens next? I have no idea. I am ready for anything. Anything but one thing. Anna, please, hold on. Without you, I have nothing to live for, nothing to dream about. Doubly so, since if not for that dream of mine, you'd be all right now.
Artyom, you know, when I found this photo of the Pacific Ocean, I just knew for some reason that we were going to go there in the end. All these rivers, mountains, deserts, they just won't do. It's ocean or bust. I believed we could make it. I did. I know I'll get there. And if I need some help, you'll be there for me. You'll save me again, won't you? Artyom, please. Stop torturing yourself. It hurts to even look at you. You and Dad, too. It's not your dream, and not his belief in the occupying forces. It's just fate. A stupid piece of cloth in the wind. Rotten concrete. An idiotic ammo dump.
Artyom, you should go. I'll give her a shot. Let her sleep a bit.
Ahem.
Come with me, bratuha. There are things to discuss.